Next guest was spot on when he correctly called January's reversal. And then after that, a mini reversal of the reversal. Now he's saying investors need to be prepared for really wild stuff in February. Charlie McElligott, I never know how to pronounce it properly.
McElligott. It's shockingly phonetic.
Managing director and head of cross-asset strategy at Nomura joins
us. Dynasty Investing.
Right now. All right. What's the dynasty?
Nothing.
So what does a reversal of a reversal mean, and what does it mean that February is going to be wild?
Yeah, so when we were, when I was last here, end of December, this entire market, you need to have a view on interest rates, whether you realize that or not as an equities investor. Late December, remarkably, because it seems so polar opposite from where we are mentally, sentiment-wise right now, was very much this view of a post-China phase one deal.
Right.
Relief rally. And that relief rally took the form of a reflation trade, right? Bonds were selling off. The curve was bear steepening. And you finally got that big cyclicals and value stock rotation over the defensive secular growth bond proxy stuff, right? Because bonds were selling off. My call in January then was that there was no true sticky secular reflationary catalyst. There's a big seasonality for treasuries in January. And in particular, in the factor world of equities, there is a major rebalancing impulse the first month of the year in January that would feed back into that long bond proxies, right? The barbell, the long secular growth stuff, meaning tech and software, the long the defensive stuff, right? That's also a bond proxy, and short the cyclicals. That's exactly what we got. It was an 11% move.
What's going to happen in February then?
So,
equities. Give me the equity story in February.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a big uptrade to be had in the next 2 weeks, actually. Certainly potential for a pretty strong impulse up. That is tied to options positioning.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, we are certainly in a band right now, both within the rate space and within equities, where if I look at dealer gamma, which is just the amount of bonds. It's a hedging construct for options market makers. Mm-hmm. And there's about $4 billion of dealer gamma at the 3,300 strike, which is about 25 handles below here in S&P. It's about $6 billion at 3,350, and another $5 billion up at 3,400.
For those of our viewers who aren't pros, they're
options,
just a little bit.
Options market makers are short options, generally speaking, to the downside.
Okay.
And generally speaking, they're long options to the upside. The clients sell to them to enhance yield. Right now, though, we're short the wings, right? There's a lot of fear story out there, both with regards to the kind of this ongoing slowdown, end of cycle story, coronavirus, global economic impact. So dealers are very short downside, which could create, ironically, with all of this hedging they have to do to be short the downside, where they have to go out and short futures or buy S&P
puts,
that creates a potential pull where into expiration next week, where if those shorts, if all those downside hedges in the market don't trigger and dealers are long all of this crash protection is going to start decaying, and they have to puke out of that stuff, and that causes a slingshot higher.
Okay, and that's a slingshot higher, though, but that's a two-week story.
Yeah, that's 2 weeks out.
It's not a fundamental story. That's just a technical story.
Yep. That's a two-week story. I think to me right now, though, why, the reversal of the reversal worked in January, right? The opposite of that December reflation trade, which was just back into momentum, back into tech stocks, back into defensive leaderships, and then you see energy, get hammered again. Right. That's kind of the pure story. To me, that's the one-year-out trade that there is no core, deep reflationary catalyst in the global economy in the absence of large-scale fiscal stimulus. And fiscal stimulus is going to be a political story. That could be a dynamic, say, if you get a move hard left with the Bernie Sanders shift.
Right.
If you were to see the House, if you were to see the Senate push left, then all of a sudden you're talking infrastructure, you're talking living wages, MMT potentials, and that could potentially proliferate around the globe, too. Germany, green bonds, Chinese stimulus, which we see is going heavy right now. Then you need to do a rethink on inflation. And then you would look at the cyclical value commodity stuff.
As we look now, you mentioned that you have to have a view on bonds and rates. 156 on the 10-year right now, ticking toward the recent lows. Does that just kind of feed back into that same process of buy defensives and tech and things like that? And just what are the limits of that crowding?
Yeah, 100% spot on there. I feel like, and I said this in December, there is no reflation catalyst. I also feel like at this kind of 150 lower band in treasury yields, that's probably a pretty rich spot too. So it still is this range trade where we're going to have overshoots in positioning. We're going to have overshoots in growth scare narratives or coronavirus narratives or Bernie Sanders narratives that will then kind of get priced out and adjusted to by the market. And then we trade to that 190 level. And those swings from kind of everything duration, the long interest rate sensitives, into the cyclical reflation, you probably want to do the opposite of both of those ends. Mm-hmm. So I do think that right now there probably is an impulse for a yields higher, stocks higher move potentially in the next 2 weeks. After that, we're going to be beholden to election risk as well as the coronavirus progression.
Election risk, Super Tuesday. Everyone's talking about this cluster of hedging happening.
Yes, so
March 3rd.
We touched on that. That has only accelerated.
Yeah.
And if you think back in October last year, we had this very similar setup. There was two big market hedges going on, both in VIX upside, kind of short term, and a hedge buying program that's in the market that really outsized market maker capacity to recycle all of that risk and cover their own option shorts, as well as the election stuff. And this, at the time, it was Elizabeth Warren. Now it's Bernie Sanders. Either way, it's viewed as a strong growth negative. U.S. re-regulation, you lose the tax haven status, corporate sure. profits negative. And that stuff is disrupting the vault curve, right, out through February, out through March, that will absolutely impact the market because dealer gamma, I know it's an intense concept, but that's what moves markets, not single stocks.